हेलो हाय एवरीवन, वेलकम टू दिस वीडियो. दिस इज अरविंद हियर. सो वी आर गोइंग टू लुक एट द मार्केट एनालिसिस फॉर द फोर्थ वीक ऑफ जुलाई. सो वी लुक एट द चार्ट्स एंड फ्रेम द ट्रेड सेटअप फॉर द कमिंग वीक. ओके, सो स्टार्टिंग ऑफ विद अ निफ्टी डेली चार्ट. एज वी वुड हैव नोटिस्ड, निफ्टी गेव अ गुड ब्रेकआउट ऑन फ्राइडे एंड फॉर्म्ड अ बुलिश पैटर्न. So in the previous video, for the third week of July, I had mentioned that we will be in a consolidation phase, that is between 10,550 to 850, and that played out almost till the end of the week. And the last 1 hour on Friday, we saw a big rally, mainly coming from Reliance, HDFC Bank, which also pushed the indexes up, right? So that was on Friday. So that is giving us a very good indication that Nifty is going into further uptrend, mainly because of two reasons. One reason is it had a breakout above this range of 10,850, which was acting as a very strong resistance, and also it had a breakout above the 200-day moving average, which was around 10,890 odd range, and closed above that at 10,900. So that is giving an indication that we can go long from here and maintain a positive bias for the coming week. Okay, now this is something which most of us would have noticed this, but let us go into finer details and look at what levels to plan for the coming week. Okay, now the first thing which I would like to notice to bring to your notice is the last 2 weeks. If you look at it, the Nifty was into a very narrow range of 300 to 400 points, and it was taking support at 10,550, which is acting as a very strong support. So unless Nifty breaks this level, I don't think there is any further downside in Nifty. In fact, many people were trying to short the index, expecting 10,000 to 10,200, 300 levels last week, but that did not happen. And even I did not initiate any kind of short positions on in the index, mainly because it was protecting the support at 10,550. So unless that is broken, I don't think there's any major reason to worry on the downside part. Okay, now since market is giving an indication there's a breakout on the upside, we can stay long. And a few factors which we have to see is, see the previous few weeks pattern, if you analyze on the daily chart. Over here in the third week of June, there was a consolidation phase. It was trading, Nifty was trading in a narrow range of 200 points. From there, it gave a breakout and it gave a very good rally up to 10,500. So from here, if you see almost 500 points rally we got. From there, again, we moved to a consolidation phase, a narrow range, that's 10,200 to 10,000. 500, another 300 point range. This whole week went in consolidation phase. Then what happens? There's a gap up, and from here a breakout happened, and we got another rally from 10,500 to 10,000, almost 10,900, right? Another 300 to 400 point rally. So Nifty seems to be moving in a very good upward direction, but it's taking some time in between to consolidate, which is very normal. Obviously, markets will not keep moving in one direction. It will take some time to consolidate, and from there it gives a breakout, right? Now the same thing is happening. This is more of an extended consolidation phase because of almost 2 weeks we have taken, a lot of time has been spent here, and there is a good indication of a breakout. So when the breakout happens after a strong consolidation, also in terms of time, there's a longer time that we have spent here, I think this could be a very very strong breakout. Okay, and also seeing the previous patterns, obviously we can expect somewhere around say 300 to 500 point rally from here, and also seeing the time that we have spent here, it could be even more than that, right? So to be very conservative, we look at 10,000, sorry, look at 11,055. That is the first level of resistance for Nifty, and if that is crossed, there is a gap which you might notice here. That gap may get filled, and 11,300 should be achieved in the coming week. And also towards the end of the week, if we're able to sustain above 11,100, I think there is another chance of further upside rally where we can even test 11,500. There is another gap which may get filled, right? Looking at the momentum, I think there is a very good chance of upward movement from here. So you can either initiate long positions, or if you're already long, you can stay invested. So RSI is above 60 as of now, 67. That is a good sign. So that's on the Nifty chart. Okay, so coming to Bank Nifty. See, Bank Nifty was always on the it's like an out I mean, it's like underperformer for the last few days, few weeks. It is also trading in a narrow range, but it gave a sign of a bullish pattern on Friday and is just crossing the 20-day moving average, right? So the levels to watch for Bank Nifty is the initial resistance comes at 22,115, and if it sustains above that, 22,600 to 620, and if that is also crossed, the final hurdle will come at this level 23,018. That is the previous high, somewhere close to that. So that is the outside and end of the Bollinger Band. So that could be a very strong resistance zone. So even if that is achieved, I think from here, from current levels itself, we are able to see another 1,000-point rally in Bank Nifty. A 1,000-point rally in Bank Nifty will approximately come to around, say, 300-point rally in Nifty. So somewhere that will put us around 11,200. That is the level which we saw in the previous chart for Nifty. So indicators are positive. We can stay long in both the indices. Okay, now coming to other data points which we have to look at is the FII data. Okay, obviously, given the momentum on Friday, both FIIs and AIIs were on the buy side. This is on the index FNO. Looking at the stock FNO, FIIs were buying, and DIIs, it's a very slow volume of selling. Coming to cash, there also you can see good buying from FIIs and some not much volume of selling in from the DIIs. So this, if it is continuing on the buy side from FIIs, I think we can expect more short covering rally, so we can obviously stay long. Right now, looking at the global markets. In terms of Europe had a mixed closing, not too positive, not too negative, kind of flat. So globally, if you might have noticed, there is very less momentum in the global scenario, and there's not much there's no fall or no big upside direction. So we look at other markets. In the Dow Jones chart, US charts, you can see here. See, Dow Jones had a good rally few days back, and it had a very strong resistance at 27,000, which got achieved, and it is not able to break out. Right now, it is kind of consolidating. There's not much of a weakness. It's forming a doji and a small bearish candle. So there's not much of a weakness here. It has got a very strong support at 26,600, followed by 26,000. So unless this is broken, I don't think there's much fall in the U.S. market. And if it manages to close above 27,000, I think it may take out the previous high, which is around 27,500, which is around almost 800 points from here. And if that is giving a breakout, I think obviously Dow Jones will eventually impact the other global markets, which may also join the rally. So there is not much weakness in Dow Jones. Coming to S&P 500 index, you can see another phase of consolidation. It's moving to the previous high, and it's forming a doji pattern, and RSI is also above 60. So there's not much negativity there also. If we have a close above, say, 3,200, I think there is more upside left in S&P. Again, that may drive the market globally on the upward direction, right? So coming to Nasdaq, which is the IT index for US markets, and it went to an all-time high, and from there starts to show some weakness, but it's just consolidating. There is not much weakness below 10,500. So mostly it may consolidate here, and we can expect some upside direction. So all the three indices are showing some kind of stability in US markets, not much of a weakness, Right, and US, even Europe are not, you know, falling too much. Coming to SGX Nifty, the way it's closed is around 10,965, almost nearing the 11,000 mark, which is also a positive sign. And obviously, we have to see how they open up tomorrow. But looking at these data points, this is all clearly indicating that we can stay on the long side. Right, so that's about the global markets and also the Nifty Bank Nifty chart. Now coming to options chain data, so I'm in the weekly options expiry 23rd July for Nifty. Looking at the open interest, it is at the highest at 11,200. That's where you see the highest open interest, okay, followed by 11,000, right? So obviously 11,200 is where a lot of people are expecting markets to close by the expiry. And coming to support, that will act as a strong resistance zone. Coming to support, I think 10,700 is where you see highest open interest, followed by 10,500. So 10,700 will act as a support zone. So that will be the range for the coming week. And if you look at the monthly expiry, that is 30th of July, let's look at what the options chain is telling us. Okay, here you can see 11,500 has the highest open interest. So most people are feeling 11,500 will be taken out by the end of the month, just another 600 points from now, which is entirely possible given the fact that, and I explained the way Nifty rallies after the consolidation phase. So there's a good chance of us hitting 11,500 also. And next open interest highest is coming at 11,000, which should be taken out this week, coming week. Okay, in terms of support, you can see here highest open interest coming at 10,500, which, as I told you, it's acting as a major support. So that is where the highest open interest is. Okay, so that's about for the monthly expiry. So all the indicators and the options chain, everything is telling us there is a good chance of further upside in the market. Now coming to stock specific views, as we all know, HDFC posted decent results. And the only cause of worry there is on the increasing NPAs, which was on the expected lines. So I don't think there's going to be a major cause of concern. And you can see on the chart, you can see obviously HDFC formed a very good bullish candle and is taking support at 1063, and from there starts to rally. It's a good chance of us testing 1100 to 1125. That is entirely possible. It may even give a gap up opening. And RSI is also nearing 60. And if that is breached, I think it may even start moving to 1150 on HDFC Bank. And coming to other stocks which gave a good rally on Friday was Reliance. Reliance gave a good, I think, almost 70-80 points rally. Okay, some reason I'm not able to open it. Okay, let me just open it. Okay, all right. So it's taking support at 1800 levels, 828 levels, and it's forming a wonderful trend reversal pattern, taking support with a doji candle. And I think next levels we can expect is 1940 and 1978, the previous high. And if it's taken out, I think it will easily go a little above 2000 levels for the coming week. And that also may push the Nifty up, right? So these are good indicators that, you know, we can expect more upside. Another stock in focus is HUL, whose results we can expect next week. On the daily chart, it is given a good breakout, and I think it is moving towards 2390. That is the next resistance level. And if that is broken, it may even test higher levels of 2420 and 2500, the previous high. That is the all-time high for HUL. So this is giving a wonderful breakout. RSI is above 70, that I think there's a good chance of a further upside in HUL. So having said that, if we come to the indices, Nifty IT was the leader last week, right? It took the markets higher. So it was mainly because of TCS and Infosys and Reliance. Nifty was bullish, even though there was a divergence between Nifty and Bank Nifty. So IT sector seems to be on the overbought zone. So there's some kind of price rejection at 17,500 levels. So it may take resistance here and it may kind of consolidate from here. But any further upside will obviously benefit the overall market. Nifty also, even though it had a small fall, it starts to show some kind of momentum and showing some kind of recovery, right? Now coming to other indices, Nifty Auto, if you look at the Nifty Auto chart, it is on the weekly chart, can see here. Okay, just a minute, let me come back. Okay, this is a weekly chart. Okay, so it is showing some kind of weakness here, forming kind some kind of a hanging man pattern here. So it may show some signs of exhaustion. But if any kind of breakout above 7200 levels, I think there's a good chance of further upside and Nifty Auto. And coming to auto specifically, I think we can go more for stocks like Hero MotoCorp or Bajaj Auto, more in the two-wheeler space than Maruti. Maruti is not showing much momentum. Also, Escorts and M&M were also looking good. And coming to other stocks, other sectors, FMCG, so we can expect HUL results the coming week.
Okay, now coming to the results that is expected in the coming week, this is going to be a major week for results in the BFSI banking sector. You can see Axis Bank results expected on 21st, Bajaj Finance and Bajaj Finserv. So Tuesday will be a very busy day in terms of results. Even HUL is going to be coming out with the results. And coming on to later part of the week, you can see L&T, Bajaj Auto and Ambuja Cements, Asian Paints, ITC and ICICI Bank. So these results will be closely monitored, and that may have an impact on the market. And ICICI Bank is coming on the weekend, so that may not have much of an impact. But the main focus will be on the banking stocks like Axis, Bajaj Finance, and also into insurance, ICICI and SBI Life. Okay, so that's about the plan for the week. So I hope you like the video. If you have any comments or questions, you can leave in the comment box. And also, all the views that I've shared is as per my personal analysis. So I recommend you to consult your financial advisor if you're taking any of the trading recommendations or any positions accordingly. So also please do your own research. Okay, so if you have any questions, leave in the comment box. I'll see you in the next video. Happy trading. Take care. Bye-bye.